Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
There is immense conference pride in the Big Ten. No conference I can think of has more games where they play for trophies, whether it's Paul Bunyan's axe, a little brown jug, an old oaken bucket. Somebody's always playing for something, but most of all, they're playing for pride. A great matchup coming in the Big Ten.
We've done all we can do here. Time to tee it up. Let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for the call. David and I will be with you at halftime.
Beautiful Bloomington, Indiana just might turn ugly as these two teams clash in today's football battle.
And now let's head down to the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Indiana is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. Sends it sailing downfield.
Well, Kirk, today we get to take a look at one of the top quarterbacks in the country. You and I have been looking forward to this. Clifford's decision-making abilities make him very effective against any defense he's ever played with.
Well, defenses have to put pressure on him and not let him get comfortable. If you allow him to scan the field, he'll simply pick you apart. If you can disrupt his rhythm, it'll give you a chance at least shutting him down.
Gets it out quickly.
They'll bring him down.
Right around the 38-yard line.
This quarterback doesn't seem to be having any trouble with the zone, does he?
He recognized the receiver was behind the coverage, and he found him with a perfect strike. That's nice passing for a first down.
He's on the run, and he's level at the 33. Clifford gains about 5 yards on the scramble out of the pocket. Chance makes it to the 24. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
Incomplete. Almost picked off.
You don't want to knock the big guy because it was a very good play, but it looked like he could have come up with the interception.
From the 24-yard line, second down. He's scrambling. He's wrapped up for the sack.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
So that sack will back him up a little now. They're looking at a difficult 3rd and 13.
Up and goes down. After the sack, it's now 4th and long. Penn State could take the lead with this field goal. It's up, looks long enough, and it's good! They line up to kick this one away. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. They come out on an empty backfield. And they make the stop at the 33-yard line.
You know, this is just amazing. You spend 6 days planning as a defensive coordinator for one guy, and then you get the other quarterback. So now what happens?
It's 2nd down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a 5 wide outlook.
And they get nice yardage on that run. Picked up a first down on that carry.
Yeah, a good job up front by the offensive line. They picked up some nice blocks to allow that back to get in there for some extra yardage.
He makes it to the 38-yard line. It's second and eight. Ball on their own 38. Right around the 48-yard line.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. We've got a second and 11. Ball on the 49. He's tackled at the 39-yard line. He's got the first. They'll call on the field goal unit. Indiana is looking to tie things up. The kick is up. So the junior kicker is unsuccessful this time. And our score, 3-0, Penn State. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Penn State has a three-point lead. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. He might have a chance. Brought down in the open field. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
Hey, watch the ball, watch the ball. Jim.
Tackled after a decent pickup. After a decent run up the gut.
That's where you fly to the ball.
He gets to about the 24-yard line. Run, and he's brought down. Second and five coming up here. Ball on the 19-yard line. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. There are three quarters remaining. Penn State's got a three-point lead. Back to the action here in the second quarter. It's been a good one and a tight one at this point. They come out in a five-wide set. Steps out of bounds at the 16-yard line. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. Penn State is up a field goal. He gets it up, and he got it. line looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Quick pass, and he's right there to knock it away.
This is a very well-coached defense. They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Scrambling around. And he can't get away from the pressure. Third down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 25. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. He's taken down at the 31. Five, maybe six on that screen pass.
It's a well-designed play to the halfback, and it worked at least to get them a medium gain on the play.
Wilson, the return man. And he can't hang on to the ball.
That's a tough play. Whether you lose the ball or not, it can mess with your head when that happens.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
Penn State is up by six. The ball is loose. One of the wide receivers picks up the fumble. From the 40-yard line. First down.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none. They don't want none of this.
Fires out to his wideout. Tackle made around the 26-yard line. Hits him hard at the 12-yard line.
Hey, watch the slant. Hey, check.
Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
After positive yardage.
Let's go, defense. Let's go, defense.
He scrambles. Keeps it, and he's got a touchdown. What a touchdown. He didn't see anyone open, so he just took it in himself.
This quarterback is fearless, and the defense needs to either spy him or walk the safeties up when they've got the ball down near the goal line.
And he hits the PAT.
A 7-play, 74-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
The score now, 13-0. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. We're about set to start things up again. Now he's scrambling.
from their own 22-yard line. It's second down. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. Fires out to his receiver. And he's taken down at the 30.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
And they're going to have to bring on the punt team.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on a pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
Check 26.
This is a great punt-blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Wilson takes it to 25. He's taken down at the 34-yard line. Penn State's offense is just clicking on all cylinders, Herbie, right now. It's everything they planned for, and it's all working.
Everything is coming together for this offense. They seem to be getting better with each series. And, you know, this game started where this team was, you know, they wondered if they were going to be able to move the ball against this defense. And I think right now, I think they seem to, as I said earlier, they seem to be growing with their confidence with each possession.
And down he goes at the 41. A 7-yard pickup on the screen play. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He's going to try and scramble. Room around the corner. And now he's going to run. He's knocked out of bounds at the 37-yard line. From the 37-yard line, first down.
47, Mike.
He gets rid of this one. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Quick strike to the receiver. Down at about the 29-yard line. He's at the 20. They'll bring him down at the 12.
Very intelligent play call. Dialing up the option on third down, and it worked like a charm.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 12-yard line. Five wide. Makes the catch and look out, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 4.
Ain't no such thing as a loss. We take the win home. 47 Mike.
And he's tackled around the 3-yard line. Tries to buy some time. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown. And he converts the extra point. Stout has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. From their own 25-yard line. Second down. Offense lines up at a 5-wide set, and the defense anticipating pass here. That's a great tackle at the 30-yard line. The quarterback was just lucky to get that pass off. He was under a lot of pressure in the pocket.
Not a bad play. They gained 5 yards out of it, and they keep moving the defense back.
Throws it in a hurry. And they make the stop at the 38-yard line.
That is money in the bank. Sometimes you just can't stop a good combination.
From their own 38-yard line, it's first down.
He's scrambling.
Tackle at the 47. Indiana is going to have to use their second time out of the half. In the shotgun and five wideouts.
Oklahoma!
He's tackled in the open field. They'll line up with five wide receivers. So they decide to bring the kicker out to try to get 3 points before the half ends. It has the distance. So at the end of the half, the Nittany Lions in front, 20 to nothing.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Ball security was a major theme coming into this game, and both offensive coordinators have to be thrilled with the fact that their offenses, first and foremost, did a good job of taking care of the ball.
And you don't see it every game, that's for sure, that both teams don't have a turnover at the half. And you usually see those critical mistakes that set up a short field for you to take advantage of. And it's definitely nice. It's nice to be able to put in a plan all throughout the week and to be able to execute it and not to be able to make those big mistakes. Because coaches will tell you, it's those big mistakes that kill you. It's okay to be rushed in the pocket as a quarterback and then throw it to your mom in the third row. Don't throw it in harm's way. Both quarterbacks done a good job, and as a result, both teams with zero turnovers in the first half.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Nittany Lions continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He's tackled at the 36. From their own 36-yard line, first down. They'll get him for a loss.
That's a great play by the defense. There's nothing like a defense being able to slip off of a block, get into the backfield of the offense, and then make a play in the backfield to be able to create some momentum possibly for this defense.
I'm coming after you! I'm coming after you! Mike 13! He's coming, he's coming!
He's on the run. He's taken down at the 38. It's third down and 7 yards to go. Ball on their own 38. He gets rid of this one, and that'll bring up a punting situation.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended, and now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
Evans awaits the snap. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the offense as they look to find the end zone yet again.
Pick it up, guys. Pick it up.
finds his way to the 29-yard line. He might have a chance. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Was one beauty of an option by that quarterback.
No question. There was no hesitation whatsoever. Once he saw that hole, he turned it upfield and left everybody in the dust.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Tackle made at about the 19-yard line. He has some room. He gets out to about the 11-yard line. Gets to about the 8-yard line. From the 8-yard line. Second down. Scrambling around, and he's taken down at about the 3-yard line. They got to him, and he did not get the first down. This one should be makeable. Might have been some early movement up front.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
Kicks up, and it's through the uprights. Is lined up to kick this one off. He just drills this one. Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt.
Down two possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Got his man, can't tack on any yardage.
Good work here by the defense to keep him from making something more out of that play.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Nice run there.
It's a nice read by the quarterback to keep the ball and pick up some yardage.
Intercepted to the 10. He's in. Another touchdown.
Great job here by the defender breaking on the ball and taking it to the house. Man, those pick sixes can really hurt an offense and have a lasting impact.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Indiana's getting stomped right now. They're unable to get anything going here in the third quarter.
Well, I think what they have to do at this point is they've got to get into a little bit more of a hurry-up mode, a little bit more urgency, score, and hope that the defense can come up with a stop and hope you can get the ball back and put more points up.
They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Got it. And he goes down quickly. We've got a second and five. Ball on the 30. He scrambles. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. Come up just shy of the first.
Good play call, almost perfect execution, except for the fact that they're not going to get the first down.
Wilson will be the return man. Oh, excellent punt. Wilson fields it at the 19. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. So at the end of three, the Nittany Lions in front, 30-0. Well, folks, we head into the fourth quarter, and this one is a blowout. Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. He makes his way to about the 45. The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Penn State up big. And now he's got room to run. Makes it to the 47. Scrambling, slides down to the ground.
That's what I'm talking about. Nice hit, baby.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
47, Mike. 47, Mike. Mike, 47. Here we go.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. They come out in a five-wide set. And down he goes, right around the 16-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 16-yard line. After a decent run up the gut.
Watch the run! Watch the run! Watch the run!
Hey, check by 47! Check by 47!
Let's go!
The middle for a nice game. This is the eighth play of this drive. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter.
Stay there.
going to try and scramble. Brought down at the 1 yard line. First down. Defense trying to prevent any more damage. First and goal inside the five.
The speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. The 5 yard line. And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Penn State up big right now in this one. Dives and he's down. The Nittany Lions know that they have to enjoy this guy while they've got him, because somewhere down the line he's going to be at the next level.
Well, that'll definitely be in his future, but for now he needs to sit back and just enjoy this performance. And really, the play caller, the quarterback, the offensive line, the receivers, the entire group as just a whole should feel good about their performance.
For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.